Hello, e-people. This is part two of the Elasticsearch lab exercises using the Olympic events dataset. There are six exercises in this part, covering the Reindex API, ingest pipelines, and index templates. If you haven't seen part one yet, watch that first as it contains all the groundwork necessary to go through this part. If you're ready to go, start up your Elasticsearch cluster, and let's begin. Okay, here we go, exercise 13. Reindex the data in Olympic-events into the new Olympic-events-fixed index created in exercise 12 and use the split games pipeline created in exercise 10. So this is going to use the Reindex API and we're going to pass it the pipeline to run the documents through on the way. So set the source index to be the Olympic-events index. And the destination to be Olympic-events-fixed. Now to run this through the pipeline, all we need to do is add the pipeline attribute to the destination block. We'll kick this off and it'll take a while, it may even time out. There we go, we can have a look at the cat tasks API to see if it's still running. Yeah, probably fixed. Let's have a look at the indices again. Now we can see here that we've got our Olympic-events-fixed index and it's got 11.3 mega data in it, but apparently zero documents. Now this will happen because no refresh has been done on the index. So the documents are there, but they're not available to be seen in search results. So we can force a refresh on the index to see the counts. So we'll make that post command, check the indices again. And there we go. We can see here that we've got the Olympic-events-fixed and it's got 206,165 documents in and that matches identically with the Olympic-events index. So that's exercise 13 done. Exercise 14 says, look at the mappings for Olympic-events-fixed. Notice how Elasticsearch has created new fields. Ooh, this sounds interesting. Let's go and have a quick look. Now, yeah, we can see that we created fields in the index with lowercase names, age, height, weight, athlete name, and so on. But in the index now, there's age, city, event, height, and they've got capitalized names. So let's have a look down here, and here are the original fields. So field names in Elasticsearch are case sensitive. The exercise says, we created the mapping for this index with the same field names as before, but we put all the field names in lowercase. Field names are case sensitive, so age with a capital A and age with a lowercase a are different, distinct fields to Elasticsearch. So we're going to work through this exercise and sort this out using a new ingest pipeline and an index template. Right, so step one, let's get this index template sorted out. Now we can piggyback on the mapping that we used originally. Just a few changes to make here. What we'll do is instead of putting this, we will take this out and we'll make a post to underscore template slash Olympic-events. One bit we need to add to this is the index pattern to use this template for. And that was indices beginning with Olympic-events dash. Right, so we'll add in the index pattern to use with a star at the end to match any postfix. Now, a quick note here. These index templates have been superseded by a new pattern called composable index templates. The exam, I think, now covers both, but this way still works fine on any version of Elasticsearch in circulation at the moment. Now, if we were to run this, it would create the index pattern and everything would be absolutely fine. It would be used for new indices with an index name beginning with Olympic-events dash. One thing we need to add in here is the second part, which was to throw an exception if any new field not defined in the mapping is used. And the way we do this is by setting the mapping to be strict. So we add dynamic strict into the mappings block. Send that, and that's our index template created. We can have a look at this by, instead of making a post, we make a get. And this is what we just created. There's some expression pieces in here as well, like order, but these only apply when using multiple index templates for the same index pattern. Exercise 15, create a new ingest pipeline called reconcile underscore fields to replace all fields with their correct field names, except for the games field. Then also execute the split games pipeline. So this is going to be a pipeline with many processes because we've got quite a few fields to update. So let's begin putting this together. So that is all the field name replacement done. The next thing to do is to run it through the split underscore games pipeline. So there's a processor just for that. So that should be that. I think that's all the fields done. All right, that's that created. Exercise 16 is to test the new pipeline with the following document. So I'm just going to copy and paste that across here. Right, so we'll leave that there, and let's do the simulate API again. Here we go. So we've got all the field names with the right case, and the split games pipeline has run. Got year 1984, season summer. Exercise 17, delete the Olympic-events-fixed index. It's gone. Exercise 18 is to re-index the data in the Olympic-events index into a new Olympic-events-fixed index using the reconcile fields pipeline. We'll reuse this post to the re-index API and just change the pipeline and give this a go. Another timeout. Let's have a look. Complete. So let's have a look at the indices again. Olympic events fixed, and we'll need to do another refresh, I think. So there's the index, apparently with 157,845 documents. So let's have a look after doing a refresh. There we go, 206,165 documents. And should we have a quick look at the data in there? And here are the documents. Everything looks good. They might see the weight, age, height and year fields in quotes here, but rest assured they are actually numbers and they're described in the mappings as a short. The fields will work just fine in any query where the field type has to be a numeric. And we don't see field names beginning with a capital letter or any duplicated field names. So it looks like we're sorted. That's part two complete. The index mapping is now in good shape and we're ready to start querying. The next part works through a few queries, aggregations, and scripted fields. I hope to see you then, so until next time, have fun, and cheerio.